Sorry to keep you waiting. I'll get...
Take this, Boruto. The light will likely return if you follow Naruto's memories. When that light shines strong, your father's memories are returning.
If that happens, I just need to hand it to you, right?
Exactly.
Okay.
Now go to your father. Get back Naruto Uzumaki's memories.
So, I'm going into the past like this?
You're going back in time to retrace the memories of Naruto Uzumaki. I'll be your guide. The nine-tailed fox spirit was sealed within your father by the fourth Hokage. And that's where Naruto's memories begin. With nine tails residing within him, Naruto dealt with persecution from the villagers. But in spite of his burden, he stayed strong, hanging on to a dream to one day become the Hokage. After graduating from the Ninja Academy, Naruto was assigned to Team 7 with Sasuke Uchiha and Sakura Haruno. The head of Team 7, Kakashi Hatake, held a training session to assess their abilities. Historically speaking, it was nothing more than a trivial competition, but to Naruto, it was his important first step to finding his ninja way.
This will be nothing like your previous training. It's a test to see what you can actually accomplish as a genin.
Did he say test?
What?
Of the 27 graduates, only 9 will be accepted as genin, and the chance that you'll fail is at least 66%.
Seeing everything happen like this, could this mean I'm inside my dad's body?
That's right. From this point on, you'll experience the life of Naruto Uzumaki, directly from his point of view. This.
I get it. But this feels pretty weird.
They're about to start.
Dang it! Well, I'm not gonna be weeded out!
Let's get started here.
Yo, hey. Yo.
Ah! My lightning style.
Don't get too
lightning
scared.
Lightning
you see how tough I am.
What the?
Dad's so determined.
Being a ninja is quite special to Naruto. It's the first step to achieving his dream.
Hey, Hokage. I know what happens after this, since his dream actually comes true. It just reminds me how amazing Dad is.
What the?
His connection to Sasuke Uchiha and Sakura Haruhi grew deeper as soon as he joined Team 7. Back then, Naruto saw Sasuke, an elite student, as his rival, and seemed to have a crush on Sasuke.
Well, she's a close friend of the family now.
Here I come!
But wow, so this is where it all started.
Eventually, he would fight in numerous battles and become a figure of central importance in the ninja world.
Don't mind if I do.
Come on.
Right here.
Better back off.
Oh, what the? My body is...
You're done collecting memories here. On to the next one.
But wait, what happened to Dad and the others after that?
Kakashi Hatake wasn't actually testing their strength. He just wanted to make sure they understood teamwork. Since they easily met his expectations, he officially welcomed them to Team 7.
Of course they did. It is those three, after all.
From there, they took on various missions as ninja. The life of a ninja is full of danger, and this is the first time Naruto fought a life or death battle.
Don't hold it against me. I had no other choice.
I'm on this, Sasuke! Don't hold me back!
I won't let you escape!
Right here!
It's the land of waves. In modern times, this spot is known as the Great Naruto Bridge. It was a great battle here to prevent the bridge from being built. Team 7 is taking on two ninja hell-bent on ending its construction. One is known as Zabuza Momochi, and the other is Hako. Hako, who you see fighting now, had a special ability called the Keke Genkai, allowing him to manipulate ice style.
So, he becomes a ninja and he's already fighting guys like this?
Let me do it. Fighting through life-or-death situations like these has been stronger. Haku lived his life as a tool of violence at Zabuza's disposal, which was not unheard of for the life of a ninja. Young Naruto was shocked to see Haku's subjugation. He'd never been exposed to such a life of servitude before. Being exposed to Haku's cruel fate made Naruto fully aware of his own ninja way. The ninja way.
Ninja way, huh?
I won't let you escape.
On to the next point in time.
Ooh.
Haku lived as Zabuza's tool of violence. Yet in the end, Naruto was able to show Zabuza how much Haku cared for him. Seeing the way Haku and Zabuza died was a turning point in Naruto's life. With this experience under his belt, Naruto moved on to his next encounter. Against a ninja feared by many, known as Gaara of the Sand.
Oh, good old Gaara.
What's the matter? Do I scare you? You should only love yourself and fight for yourself. That is the definition of strength.
Thought he was strong, because he only fought for himself, and he was always alone. No, that's not what real strength is all about.
So Dad and old Gaara are fighting each other.
Clash between two enormous villages, Leaf and the Sand, caused the destruction. Gaara was the secret weapon of the Hidden Sand, due to the tailed beast known as Shukaku, sealed within it.
Tailed beast? Just like Dad.
Correct. He was in the same situation as Naruto, holding a tailed beast inside and being persecuted by the villagers.
Oh, Gaara has some killer attacks, huh?
At this point in Gaara's life, he couldn't trust anyone. But the one to soften his closely guarded heart was none other than Naruto Uzumaki. Although their situations were similar, Naruto's connection to his friends made him stronger. Gaara saw this, and he wanted it too.
Let's do it! Let's do it!
Here goes! Not fruit toast! Uzumaki! 2K! Arise!
This battle goes on forever.
After encountering Naruto, Gaara began to walk in the light. And I'm sure you know what happened after that.
Uh-huh. He was accepted by all the villagers and became Kazekage.
Naruto's spirit has influenced so many around him. Some are guided to the light, as Gaara was, while others have drifted toward darkness. Sasuke chose the latter path. Naruto reached out to Sasuke in a desperate attempt to stop him. He considered Sasuke an irreplaceable friend.
Why, Sasuke, why? How could it have come to this? I don't understand!
I have my own path to follow. My own goals are all that matter now.
Sasuke was out to kill his older brother Itachi. It was his long-standing desire for revenge. Yet at the same time, he knew he wasn't strong enough to do it.
And that's why he left the Hidden Leaf?
Here I come!
Sasuke had been tempted by Orochimaru.
What?
Sasuke believed that Orochimaru could make him strong enough to defeat his brother. Sasuke became resentful of Naruto's rapid progress as a ninja, and it pushed him toward that path of darkness. At any rate, Sasuke was greatly troubled, and he made the bitter decision to leave after much thought. Naruto was special to Sasuke as well. One of those rare people he considered a close friend. Yet he was willing to sever that connection for revenge, in search of the power he needed to kill his older brother.
What did Sasuke have against his brother?
His clan, Uchiha, was destroyed by Itachi. Sasuke was filled with hatred because of it.
Did that actually happen, though?
These are all facts that have been covered up.
No escape!
Desires and ambitions pile up through the years, which ultimately shape our history.
Here I come! Too slow!
It continued to go back and forth without a decisive result. It provoked Naruto to unleash his ultimate power, using everything in his repertoire. He was still unable to stop Sasuke. Naruto refused to give up. Once his next chance had surfaced, he immediately took action. He decided to embark on a journey to train together with his new master, Jiraiya, the legendary Sanin. And several years later, history would once again grow turbulent.
To think those two had such a crazy past. I never knew about any of this. What's this?
Your collected memories changed to light, gathered in a single spot.
I get it. So if the light gets strong enough, Dad gets his memory back, right?
Correct.
Nice. I've got this figured out now.
But first, since you've collected all the memories up to this point, you should head back to the Time Reservoir. It seems a fascinating development has begun.
Fascinating development?
Boruto, changes are happening in this space because you started returning the memories.
What do you mean?
This place is built on the space they Sinanashiro created. Therefore, her memories are mixed into the crevices of the space. Normally, those memories would not come to the surface, but this space isn't under her control now. That's why they reacted to the space, and her Kiseki appeared.
So, So if I touch that, I can see Nanashi's past?
Whether you do it or not is up to you. However, if you want to know more about her...
Of course I'll look. I hardly know anything about her.
What a splendid ability. You will be our weapon from now on. If we implant another mission soon, you can multiply its effects.
Oh, my weapon does not need any time on today. Not a single be perfect for you.
A permanent mark. You better fool this time.
I quit your trying. I'm trying to get you anywhere.
Why don't you get back to what you were working on the time?
Yeah, no.